about Ron Paul. I'm still not ready to vote for. I'm really ready to get on board with the Ron Paul Express. There's three areas that still holding me back. The first and maybe foremost is the fact that his followers are the people that I don't want to be associated with in that capacity. Though Ron Paul supporters are fervent, they're typically pretty mean and arrogant and have this sort of negative attitude that really doesn't compel me to be a part of who they are. That makes me think about the fact that kids are often like their parents. Followers are often like the people they follow. Here's a quick suggestion for you Ron Paul followers. If you want to get somebody on your side, the best way to do it is not browbeating them and berating them for being uninformed or ill-informed and stupid. Instead of pointing out the negatives in their argument, try pointing out the positives in your argument. Meet them halfway. The other thing that bothers me is that Ron Paul is really a destroyer, not really a creator. He has a lot of good ideas about what to bring down, what to abolish, what to cut. I haven't heard a lot of ideas about what to create and how government does work in our lives. The libertarian, Austrian economic idea of totally laissez-faire, that's something I can get totally on board with. Can a leader really lead when all he's doing is abolishing things, cutting things? I mean, as president, he's gonna have to run things. He's gonna have to have creative ideas to bring things together, which brings me to my next point. Ron Paul's whole domestic agenda, these things, this cutting and abolishing, all depends on whether or not he can get congressional approval. He has to get people in Congress to work with him. And you think Obama has trouble getting Congress to work with him. He's just got to deal with like 23 Tea Partiers. Ron Paul has people on both sides of the aisle that just utterly disagree with him and don't even see him as a serious candidate. Therefore, it'd be hard for him to get people to go along with him in Congress. So I'm really afraid that if he became president, he'd be a do-nothing president. He'd get in there and try to cut all these things and nothing would really, I mean, he would be able to, the only thing he'd be able to do is really start demolishing our military presence abroad and weakening our defense, if you ask me. That's a point of contention, but really, those are the areas he'll be able to control as president. And those are the areas I least agree with him on. So as always, feel free to like this video, dislike it if you didn't like it, of course. A lot of Ron Paul fans are going to dislike it. But feel free to engage me in this conversation in the comment section below. And also, I'll expand a little bit more on my thoughts below. Once again, thanks for watching, and keep up the good work.